Hi, I'm John Sheridan from the Hopkinton Fire Department of Massachusetts. We're here at Pierce in Appleton, Wisconsin, doing final acceptance testing on our twin Enforcer pumpers. We went with the Enforcer chassis again. It's a close twin to our Quint, which we purchased from Pierce about 3 years ago. A big thing for us was keeping uniformity across the fleet, and having two more Enforcer chassis with the same cab layout to match our ladder was big for our crews. One of the biggest reasons that we went with the Enforcer cab and chassis was the single piece windshield, given increased visibility for the driver operators, and keeping the same chassis across the fleet, all the controls are in the same place, so it's easier for the guys as they cross-staff different trucks. Moving back to the crew cab, all of our three trucks will have four-person cabs, two rear-facing jump seats. We have pack tracker on the back walls, an EMS cabinet, space for water rescue equipment, and a refrigerator for rehab supplies. Each of these seats will be outfitted in front of them with a set of irons and a water can, so all riding positions on the three trucks will be the same. All right, and keeping as the same standardization as our ladder truck, both pumpers are outfitted with a TAC 4 front end, independent front suspension. The TAC 4 has proven to be awesome on our ladder truck, and we're looking forward to having the same maneuverability and turning radius with these two pumpers. Keeping with the theme of functionality for a firefighter, all trucks have a 6-foot roof hook on the back. As we come back to the pump house, it's a Waterous 1500 GPM pump. And between the two pumpers, we tried to lay out the pump panels as identical to the ladder as possible. So just to make life easier for a pump operator, whether you're pumping either the engines or the Quint. Each wheel well trough on the two pumpers has a wheel well, has a trough for feeder lines to kind of make life a little bit easier for the driver operator. Some of the stuff that you can't see with the truck, we're in New England, so the chemicals they use on the roads are kind of harsh. So we went with galvanized frame rails, stainless battery box, and a stainless fuel tank. First compartment back from the pump house is the driver operator's compartment. We went with pack track mounting on the back so we can neatly organize all the adapters and fittings. And we have a slide out tray for the engineer's PPE, SCBA, and flashlight. Our driver's side high side compartment on both of these pumpers and the ladder features a swing out tool board for the ancillary hand tools. We'll have triple SCBA bottle storage here with the fourth spare SCBA bottle here. We wanted to keep the spare SCBA bottles on the pumpers on the side of the truck that's gonna have the driver operator. So when a member comes out to get a spare cylinder, there'll be a member there to help them out. This rear compartment on both pumpers and the ladder is gonna house our hydraulic rescue tools. We run a fair amount of the Massachusetts Turnpike and another highway. So once this gets back to the dealer, this is gonna get outfitted with a full set of hydraulics, cribbing, and all the other necessary tools to run an extrication. With these two pumpers, we worked pretty hard with our dealer to have the right combination of a lot of cubic footage of storage space in the cabinets, keep a 750 gallon water tank and get the rear hose bed as low as possible to make deploying and racking hose easier. It took a lot of work, but the engineers here at Pierce were able to come through as always. Ground ladder and pike pole storage in the rear. This rear compartment on the officer side on both of our pumpers as well as our Quint is where we house our power saws. And again, once this gets back to the dealer, this compartment will be outfitted with a floor mounted roll out tray to make getting power saws in and out easier, as well as an additional shelf to house spare chains, blades, gas, mix oil, that kind of thing. This side of the truck, we have two swing out doors in the wheel well for extinguisher storage. And this high side compartment on the officer side on the pumpers and the ladders where we're gonna house our rapid intervention equipment and our standpipe bundles. This forward compartment is where we house our portable generator, PPV fan, as well as this shelf right here will get outfitted with all of the associated battery chargers for our different power equipment. One of the things the engineers here at Pierce were really able to help us out with was getting a spot to recess a booster line up in the dunnage area. We have a fire station where the overhead door height's relatively low, so keeping this truck at a max height of 9.5 was a challenge, but they were able to do it and still have a booster hose with 100 feet. We've run a lot of grass fires on the side of the highway, and having a booster line in the trucks again is going to make life a lot easier. Again, officer side, we have a well storage for feeder lines. One of the other main factors that led us to choose the Enforcer was the amount of seating space, not just for the officer, but the driver operator as well. PPE is only getting bulkier. The Enforcer allows the person riding the officer seat to have the most amount of space and still be functional riding up there. Once this arrives back at our dealer, it's going to get mounted with, outfitted with radio, MDT tablet, thermal imaging camera, a gas meter, that kind of thing. Front bumper's pretty basic. We have a trough storage for 150 feet of trash line. We run a lot of car fires on the highway. Being able to stretch off the bumper makes it a lot easier instead of having to pull a cross lay. And we were able to also spec out and outfit a front intake. On behalf of the Hopkinton Fire Department, I want to thank Patrick Whitney from Allegiance Fire Rescue and all the folks here at Pierce Manufacturing that have given us another great experience in the final inspection and acceptance testing of these two engines.